time.
We're here to have a conversation in a prayerful way, so I don't think we should have a debate in front of the press on this. We came in here in good faith, and we're entering into a discussion in the public view.
But it's not bad, Nancy.
No.
It's called transparency.
I know. It's not transparency when we're not stipulating to a set of facts.
Nancy Pelosi really tried her best to stop Donald Trump from talking in front of cameras this morning, and afterwards she explained why.
I hear some of the reporters saying, Fox reporters saying, why did we not want transparency in this discussion? We didn't want to contradict the president when he was putting forth figures that had no reality to them, no basis in fact. We have to, if we're going to proceed in all of this, have evidence-based, factual, truthful information about what works and what doesn't. I didn't want to, in front of those people, say, you don't know what you're talking about.
All right, in a little more than 3 weeks, House Democrats will vote for their next speaker. And today, Nancy Pelosi acquitted herself in a way that should put to rest any argument about whether she's up to that task. On camera, she made it clear the president can't just have his border wall since the House controls the budget. And in January, Democrats will control the House. And behind closed doors, she repeatedly made it clear what the wall really represents for Trump. Quote, it's like a manhood thing for him, as if manhood could ever be associated with him, this wall thing. Talk more about Nancy Pelosi's leadership. I'm joined by former Senator Barbara Boxer, Democrat from California, and Christina Greer, Associate Professor of Political Science at Fordham University. Thank you both for being here. Senator Boxer, you know Nancy Pelosi well. Yes. It is interesting, in 2018, there are still people who doubt her moxie because most people should have been over that in about, 2003?
Yeah, I know Nancy since the 80s, can you imagine? And we served together in the House. I was there for 10 years before I went to the Senate. She's such a pro. And it occurs to me, because I've been behind these closed-door meetings for so long, that she knew that if we were serious, if she and the president and Chuck Schumer were serious, they could get to the bottom of these problems. But he wanted to set a trap. And he was nasty to her, he was nasty to Chuck, and at the end of the day, he walked into the trap himself, and people saw he was not prepared, he was nasty, and just, again, a failure, a complete failure.
Christina, this is interesting what Senator Boxer says, because, in fact, Nancy Pelosi is one of those few people in Washington whom, if you get in a room and you try and come to a deal, you can make a deal with, because she knows what she can bring in terms of votes. So while we haven't seen her in this role in the last few years, this should surprise no one. You could get a deal with Nancy Pelosi.
Oh, definitely. I mean, you know, everyone always says Nancy Pelosi knows how to count. I, of course, keep telling my students, this is Nancy D'Alessandro from Baltimore. Her father and her brother were both mayors of Baltimore. She's the only girl with five other brothers. I mean, she knows what she is doing.
Right.
She's been in the job for a very long time. She respects the office. I think the best thing that she said to the president today was, you know, Chuck and I are the first branch of government. And you could see he didn't really understand what she was saying, because it's so obvious that this president has yet to read the Constitution. In Article of the Constitution, the framers lay out the legislative branch. It's not until Article 2 of the Constitution where they talk about the executive. So she's essentially saying, we are representing the American people. That is who has sent us forth, and you don't have the votes. You had 2 years of unified government. That means President Trump, you controlled the House, the Senate, and the presidency, and you didn't get this done.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you don't have unified government, and I'm letting you know for a fact that you don't have the votes. So, I mean, the president, unfortunately, time and time again, just walked into, they're not even traps that they were setting for him. These were just facts that he walked into. We didn't talk about Mexico paying for the wall. He said that the wall is being built. We know that that's not the case. He's saying that people are bringing over diseases and, you know, they're...
That's remarkable.
Well, people
that's
buy it.
That's good and old-fashioned, but it's remarkable.
Well, if it works, it works.
Yeah.
And clearly his base really does believe it. And so she's walking him through all of the untruths, but she's also walking the American public through the facts. And so she's trying to be respectful of the office, because she actually understands her role and his role. The problem is the president doesn't understand his role.
Senator Boxer, let's talk a little bit about Nancy Pelosi. Her popularity is something that is remarkable, but there always are challenges. Nobody fielded a challenge this time, but there were people who suggested that she shouldn't be the speaker. Her unfavorable ratings tend to be quite high, which is understandable given the role she's played in politics for a long time. There are a lot of Republicans who have campaigned on the basis that Nancy Pelosi should be the speaker, because they think it's good for Republicans. After you look at what happened today, people can't really be thinking that.
No way. I mean, she, again, knows what she's doing. It's not only that she can count votes, she knows the facts. And she sat there and she kept trying to get the president in a very calm way to dismiss the press and get to work. Instead, he kept throwing out things which were not true. Oh, we're building so much of the wall. And Nancy just said, to discuss the facts. So she's a great strategist. And by the way, she pointed out that in this lame duck session, he still controls mm-hmm. all the votes. Mm-hmm. She kept saying, prove it to us. You keep yep. saying you can get it through the House. Mm-hmm. By the way, he can't. She knows that.
So, Christina, to what degree is this dangerous, though? Because this isn't why you end up as the Speaker of the House. This isn't why you end up as one of the greatest vote counters and politicians of all time to have it out in the Oval Office with Donald Trump. She needs to, in order to continue what she started this time around, have a victory in 2 years. Can she fall into this trap of arguing with Donald Trump?
Well, I don't think she'll fall into that trap because Nancy Pelosi has been in Washington, D.C. for far too long. She's never probably seen someone like this entity that we have in the presidency. However, Nancy Pelosi respects the job. And I think we've seen already with how she's sort of welcomed in these new legislators, where she's understanding that she's going to pass the baton in various ways. Obviously, the new diverse Democratic Party that's coming in. She understands that in 2 years, the Democratic Party not only needs to control and contain the president, but they really need to set forth an agenda. And, you know, Rahm Emanuel and Barack Obama got a lot of credit for Obamacare, mm-hmm. but we know that the underbelly of how that got done was Nancy D'Alessandro Pelosi.
Thank you to the two of you for helping us analyze this tonight. Barbara Boxer, former senator from California, Christina Greer, thank you both. And that is all in for this evening. I'm Ali Velshi. Thank you for hanging out with me for the last few nights.